Bonanza, a piece from the standard classical repertoire. I'd like to continue now with a couple of pieces by the flamenco guitar player and composer Paco Peña. The first is called El Nuevo Día, which means the new day, and the second one is called Herencia Latina.
Thank you.
In addition to classical and flamenco music, I'm also quite interested in jazz, particularly Latin jazz. And I have with me a special device which enables me to sound like there's two guitars playing at the same time. What I can do is I can play in a section of guitar music, and then that'll sort of play around, it'll loop around, and then I can play something else on top of it, so it simulates the effect of playing two guitars at the same time, just in case you thought I was cheating or something. Or, you know. So that's what's happening there. This piece, anyway, it's from a film called Black Orpheus, the theme tune from that film. Thank you. Now from the standard classical guitar repertoire. This is by the composer Isaac Albéniz, and it's called Asturias. Thank you. The piece I'd like to play for you this evening is a traditional dance, which is a regional dance from the southwest area of Spain, from the city of Seville, and this is called Sevillanas. I think I'm going to play something jazzy again now, and this is one of my favourite musicians, favourite jazz musicians, a guitar player called Pat Metheny, who I've admired for quite a number of years. And this composition is called James, which is actually dedicated to the musician James Taylor, who's one of my dad's favourites, I know. Yeah, very appropriate.
Thank you.
compositions now. Within flamenco music, you have standard rhythms and formats, but within that, you're free to either improvise or have short composed sections that fit in with that particular structure. And this is a style of flamenco known as soliaris, which means solitude, and has a quite a deep, sort of very somber sort of mood to it. But I've done my own interpretation and composed my own sections that fit in with this style of music. So this actual piece is called La Tierra Seca, which means the dry earth, soliaris.
Thank you.
play another piece of flamenco music now. And this is also one of my compositions. And this is a style of flamenco music which originates from the town of Jerez de la Frontera, right in the very southwest, near the in the Cádiz province, actually. And it's actually one of the fastest and most exciting forms of flamenco, known as burrerías. And it's danced, it's played on the guitar and it's sung as well. And more lately, it's starting to be played on all kinds of different instruments. So this is my own interpretation called Las Tendillas, which is a square in the city of Cordoba, which I find very inspiring because a lot of my favorite musicians are from that city. So this is Las Tendillas, Burrería.
Thank you.
very much indeed. I've just noticed that the battery's running really low on this thing, so just bear with me a second whilst I change it. Whilst he's doing that, I'll just tell you about the next piece. I'll play another one of my compositions, which I actually wrote with my brother a couple of years ago. And we're at my house and sitting in the conservatory. And it was midsummer, but it was like the heaviest storm we've ever seen. You know, sitting in the conservatory, and you can imagine in the conservatory it's like really, really noisy. So trying to write a tune, trying to play guitar in those conditions was really difficult. So we had to sort of just play louder and louder in order to sort of hear ourselves. And this song came out of it anyway. It's called Lluvia del Verano, which means summer rain. Okay, I'm going to finish off with a piece by who, in my opinion, is the greatest guitar player that's ever lived, that sadly died a couple of weeks ago, aged only 66. Absolutely incredible, phenomenal player that just really developed the art form of flamenco and took it to much wider audiences than just Spain. And it was just a phenomenal talent, brilliant, virtuoso player. So I'd like to play one of his pieces, which is called Entre Dos Aguas, which is probably one of his most famous works.